Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, we got the market talk. We haven't done one of these in quite a few days. I don't know about quite a few, but we do get the Mutt 10 Legends today, so that is kind of why I want to give you guys a quick little overview on that and go over the market as a whole. I don't really got much else planned yet for today, so I really got to get thinking, got to get back into the lab and start thinking of some video ideas for the day. If you guys got any video ideas, comment them down below. We'd love to hear them, although by the time you guys comment them, I probably already have three done. So in that case, I'll definitely try to use them for tomorrow. But if you guys got any good ideas, always make sure to comment them down below. Because a lot of the videos I do are a lot of your comments. And people are, you guys see comments all the time saying, wow, you made a video of my comment. And it's true, I use a lot of your video ideas. Or I'll take a culmination of a bunch of comments and I'll make it into a video. So whatever you guys can give me to help me out, that'd be great. Just letting you guys know, I do go to school on Tuesdays and Thursdays. For college, obviously, so those are probably going to be the days where I have a lot of things pre-recorded early, nothing really live, you know, in that sense. Not that YouTube is ever live, but in the sense that, like, content and stuff are usually, everything's pre-recorded in that sense. Nothing's going to be, like, anything that comes out, like, between 12 and 5 probably won't be on top of that, which kind of does suck, but I try my best to get it all done, guys. Now, for today's market talk, you know how I like to run this. I run it through the auction block, typically. It's the most efficient way to do it, guys. But before we get into the video, if you are new to the channel, make sure to go down below, smack the sub button, boys. We are really close to 8k. We're, I believe, at like 7.6k subs right now. We're grinding to 8k, boys. I want to thank you guys so much for all the support as of late, and all the likes, all the subs, all the views, all the comments, all the feedback, all the constructive criticism, all of it helps, guys. Thank you so much for making this a reality and allowing me to do this on a daily basis. So if you guys are new, smack the sub button. You won't regret it. You guys will love the future content, and if you haven't already, smack the like button. If you're a loyal sub, you like the market talk, you like the channel, best way to show support is by hitting this like button. So guys, let's get this video to 200 likes for the market talk, and comment down below, like I said, video ideas, constructive criticism, and some feedback. And guys, let's get into this video. So heading on over to the auction block, boys, over to the auction house. I like to start it off with the 80-81s. Like I always say, these don't change too much just because of the nature of 80-81s. They're so low, they can't go much lower, because if they go much lower, they just sell out. Pretty much things stay at their training value. So if they go below a certain price, people are gonna buy them for training, and then they come right back up. That is what trading does. It keeps the market steady. So 80s are at about 12k right now, so they're still kind of stagnant. These won't move too much. Pretty much they stay between 10 and 14k, and that's actually a big difference. If they're at 10k, it's a good training value. If they're at 14k, they're a bad training value. At 12, they're an inefficient training value, but they're not horrible. Now going to the 81s, these are typically, yeah, around 13k. Nothing's really changed on this front, which is kind of expected for the most part. I mean, it is 80s, 81s. Like I always say, you can't really, you could kind of tell if these are like, if the 80s were at 10k, you could say, oh, the market's down. Although it's only 2k, it does make a big difference in terms of other things. Now, 82s, 83s. 82s are at 19k, so actually a little bit up. These cards at a point last week were like at 16, 17k. So these are up right now. Obviously, not. It's Thursday. I always tell you guys, Wednesday and Thursday is horrible. Like, there's nothing, the market's always the most dead. So I'd like to update you guys. Pretty much on Wednesdays and Thursdays are the days I say never buy cards. I say this is kind of the time to sell cards, in my personal opinion. Although the Mutt 10 card does come out today, which I will get to in a little bit, as far as how to attack that and what that will do for the market. Now, the 83s were usually 24K. They're at 25 now, so things are slightly up, as you guys can see. 84 to 85s. We got the 84s coming in around 35k. They were like 33, 34, so nothing's changed too much on that front. Now, let's see where the 85s are. 85s are typically like at 40k-ish, 45k. Let's see. I can never. 85s are always so far down. So they're at 50k right now, 49k. Wow. Okay, so yeah, the market's up right now. I kind of told you guys that. Now, I'm going to go to a set in a second to show you guys before I finish the whole auction block. So at the 86s, we got them at 65k. That's standard. Like I always say, if the 86s go below 60k, things are looking good for the market. Like, that's a good indicator right there. They sit at 65K. They're below 60K. They're a good training option. And the market's probably on the trend down. Now, there's some 87s that are sneaky values. Not at this exact moment, because obviously the market is down. 87s do go for 86K. But sneaky values at 87 are like, well, they're up right now. But Julio Jones, Antonio Brown, Fletcher Cox, a lot of these guys were like 85K a week ago, 88K. So when you find those cards for that price, they're definitely good, because the season does kick off today. Tonight, Thursday night, Packers versus Bears. That's when the season kicks off. And you guys know anything about how Madden works and how football works? Pretty much a lot of current day players are a lot more valuable during the season. So guys like Corey Dillon and all these other guys like Team Diamonds laying around, they're less valuable once the season starts. Because once the season starts, the guys like Odell, Todd Gurley, Luke Kuechly, Julio Jones, Antonio Brown, Fletcher Cox, those guys are going to be getting upgrades weekly. Team will not, you know,
weekly as in multiple cards, not like one specific guy is going to get a bunch of cards. Odell might get one for a team of the week with the Browns next week. You never know. So you always want to have these cards. When they're cheap, buy the base elites that are cheap. Right now they're not cheap, but when they are cheap, you know they're going to get an upgrade and they're going to skyrocket in price when their card comes out. And then for the most part, these 87s like Mahomes haven't really moved too much. They did fluctuate at one point because of the free Nat pack, and they haven't really went back up since because a lot of people probably got them for really, really cheap. Jalen Ramsey looks like he'll be on the back on the come up. Now, guys, something you want to be on the lookout for specifically today. So coming over to sets, right? I've mentioned this in a bunch of videos, but for people who haven't watched those videos, let me go over this. The Madden Ultimate Team 10 completion right here. So we got linebacker and halfback already came out. So we can't worry about those. What could potentially come out today is a safety, defensive lineman, cornerback, wide receiver, offensive lineman, a quarterback, and tight end. Now, one of these cards will come out today. Now, whatever position drops today will be the position that is most affected today. As we've seen from history repeating itself with Madden, things tend to repeat themselves. Like, it's a known fact. Things that have happened already probably will happen again. So when Bo Jackson, the halfback, came out, the halfback market crashed. Marcus Allen dropped like 70K. Dalvin Cook even didn't get that expensive because Bo Jackson's still out. Halfbacks are going to struggle to stay, can maintain value right now until they're better than Bo Jackson. Obviously, it's a limited time card, so there's only so much it can affect, because I don't really understand that, right? Because it is a limited time card, so not everyone can even have him. So I don't really understand what the hype was, but the thing I get is that you can power Bo Jackson to an 89 overall stock, so technically you could still get one of the best running backs in the game. Same with Patrick Willis. Patrick Willis, when he came out, he destroyed the linebacker market. Bad. Like, Bobby Wagner went from 190K to 120K, literally within minutes of it coming out. So that is something that greatly affects the market. So that is why you want to be on top of this. So today, if a top-tier safety like Sean Taylor or Troy Polamalu comes out, if it either be a strong or a free, whichever free or strong safety that comes out, I don't really know which one it will be, that market will probably die. So if a strong safety comes out, today might be the day to pick up a Ken Houston. Or you might want to already sell them. It all depends. Like, I'm not saying sell them because you don't really know what's going to come out. But I kind of want to be ahead of the curve on these, right? So, like, I haven't really bought players for this reason. Because when the quarterback comes out, Mahomes and all those quarterbacks' prices will go down quite a ton. Because you can obviously power these guys up to almost 90 overall. So, they're technically still have an option to be the best cards in the game. Now, as far as cornerbacks, if a cornerback drops, guys like Jalen Ramsey might go down even more. Willie Brown, Mel Blount. Defensive line, you might get guys like Fletcher Cox. Let's see. Reggie White, DeMarcus Lawrence, Aaron Donald might be coming down. If you get a linebacker, which I know they already did linebacker, they don't have an outside linebacker. Let's see wide receiver, like guys like Hopkins, Rice will come down a lot. There's Odell will come down a lot. So there's a lot of ways to be going about this, guys. So the best thing you guys can do, get in touch with the Madden community, head on over to Twitter, be on top of it. When you see the drop of this card, be ready. Because when they drop the next card that's going to come out and they announce it, that cards within that position will go down quite a ton. Let's go back to the auction block to finish this. But guys, just a quick little tip. Stay in touch with what's going to happen. Stay ahead of the curve. Because if you don't, most likely, you will get burned by the inevitable card killing your position that you might have a lot of. If you have Jerry Rice, DeAndre Hopkins, and Odell Beckham Jr., you might lose a few hundred K total between all of them when all is said and done. Now, 88s, 89s, 88s out of 120K, these were about 110 a week ago. So it all depends. Typically, when the heavyweights and flashbacks first drop, you can probably get them for a little around 110, which will be the best trading value in the game and a good value in general. Is it a resale price? No, because you can only resell them for 120. But it's a good keeping slash selling trading price. See, Bobby Wagner's still trying to recover from the crash. Obviously, they will come back up, but they will not retain their old value that they once had. Let's see. The 88s, some like D-Hop, are pretty cheap, actually, in my opinion. But D-Hop's kind of overrated, in my opinion. I have him, and he's just really slow and kind of hard to use for anything. I wish he was a little bit faster, but, you know, I make the most of it with him. I still start him. Now, 89s do start at around 185. These I've seen as low as 150, 160. I've seen Larry Allen at 160. I've seen Michael Strahan at 160. I've seen Marcus Allen at 155. It all really depends on the time of day. Legend Saturday, Mutt 10 limited time legend, flashbacks, heavyweights, new packs. It all depends. Now, with the season kicking off today, could there be a kickoff promo at 10:30? Quite possibly. But with the hurricane and all the delay of content, I really don't know. I could be wrong, but I feel like today would be a veteran day, if I remember correctly. But if it is a kickoff promo, that could greatly affect things. But I don't know if they dropped the kickoff promo today, or I don't really know how they're going to go about that, guys. But if they did drop today, that would be pretty awesome. Now, coming over to the 92 to 93s, which is just Kurt Warner. Always like to check his price, 620. He was at like 185. He's still hovering around a similar price. Andrew Luck will forever be an expensive limited-time quarterback that would just sit there, so don't worry about him. Guys, that is about it for the video. Do I recommend Kurt Warner? No. He does get Hot Route Master, which is a really good chemistry, which allows you to pretty much, you can hot route anyone on the field for any hot route that you could potentially have a Kurt Warner, which kind of limits the amount of abilities you need to put on wide receivers. But He is overpriced. He is slow. And trust me, I've been playing that Superstar KO mode. And because of trying out Escape Artist, I know now that I need Escape Artist in Madden 20. So I will be waiting for the next mobile quarterback, and I will go all in on that quarterback. And I'm so hyped for when that finally comes out, guys. But that is about it for the video. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to go down below. Smack the like button. Let's get this video to 200 likes. Can you guys hit that goal? Be greatly appreciated. And if you haven't already, smack the sub button, boys. Let's see how fast we can get to 8K. Come on, everyone watching, just hit the sub button. Join the race for 8K. We're so close, guys. That'd be greatly appreciated also. And comment down below any constructive criticism, any feedback you guys got, any video ideas. I'll greatly take some video ideas. I posted like 100 videos this month, so you guys got to know that I'm going to be slowing down soon. Not as much. I'm still going to be posting 3 times a day, but the bangers, you know, those great videos. I can't remake videos. So just in that sense. So if you guys have anything, comment it down below. But that is about it, guys. Turn on the noti bell to get notified every time I post a brand new video. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm out. Peace.